Thanks for coming out. I appreciate it. I appreciate the support. And I really want you guys to understand that. That's one of the reasons why I like to do stuff like this in cities, is to like let you understand that it's real for me, that I'm not just somebody behind a camera that just does motivation just to do it. It's really my heart and I really care about it. Like, look at me as some type of inspiration for your life. Like, not saying like, oh, I want to be like Trent, but to say like, if Trent can do it, I can do it. So we all have struggle, we all have pain that we go through. And one of the things that I learned with my life, and you might have heard me talk about this before, maybe you haven't, but I always break life down into three parts, right? When you're going through, whether it's a relationship, whether it's a dream that you have, whether you lost something in your life. For me, it was football that I care so much about. For you, it might be a relationship, it might be a family, whatever it may be. I feel like you can take these three R's and apply to anything in life. And I'll tell you right now, is it gonna be easy? No. Like I said, that's the number one thing I get on my comments. Trent, easier said than done. I'm like, duh, everything is, right? But when you're hungry, like, is it easier just to say you're hungry than it is to actually go cook the food? It is, right? When you're hungry, what do? You go whip it up, right? Because you're hungry, simple. And so when you're hungry for change, like, you will make it. You don't care how hard it may be, how impossible it may seem. Like, where I'm standing at right now is crazy to me, because when I look at New York, I'm like, I'm actually in New York talking to people. Like, I want you guys to understand that. It might seem like simple to you guys, but to me, this is incredible. Because I remember right now when I was in my room, when I was depressed, when I was hurt, when I felt like my life was over. Now I'm like standing in my impossibility, what I thought was once impossible. So realize you can operate life from two mindsets, right? A progressive mindset or a limited mindset. And a lot of us, what we do, we live inside our limitations. The first thing that happens are, they will never change, or I can't change, or I can't do that, I'm not good enough. The main thing of depression in life, the main problem, is people think they're not good enough for whatever reason. And so let me tell you right now that you're great enough. Whatever it is you wanna do, you can do it. I'm living proof. Living proof. Like I said, rehab time was from the bottom. Nobody. I didn't get a cosign. I didn't get some platform somebody gave me. But it became my life. And so when you're hungry for your change, if you're hungry for making a dream come true, you're hungry for a relate, whatever it may be, it can happen, but you got to make it happen with your life. So it's these three R's that I apply to anything. Anything I go through, anything I experience, I apply these three R's. The first R is reality. Probably the hardest thing. A lot of us, the reason why we don't make a change, because we never face our reality. And like I said, acceptance is freeing. You don't have to accept and say like, okay, I'm a weak person, but you gotta say, this happened to me. Because a lot of us, what we try to do, we try to win our war by running from our battles, right? We run away from our fear, thinking that when we come back, it's gonna be gone all of a sudden. It's still there. And the longer you run, the longer you delay your healing. The longer you delay your dream, your vision, whatever it is. Like, go embrace that. The challenge or the obstacles, whatever it may be, go embrace it. Who cares if you don't succeed? You know what people say, accomplishment is the greatest thing in life. I disagree with that. The attempt to accomplish this, taking a step, that's an accomplishment in itself. Because most people won't do that. Most people, what they do is they sit in pain and they complain and they say, I want things to change without making no changes, right? We sit there and we hope things will be better, but we're not doing no better. And so if you want something to change in your life, accept that reality, period. And say, you know what, I'm not gonna let this limit my life no more. It might be hard, it might be tough, but I'm gonna make it happen. And you don't have to have it all figured out. I didn't know I had a vision, but I didn't have a plan with rehab time. My only plan was to not be where I was at. I didn't know where I was going. I got this question yesterday in one of my meetings. There's like, what is your plan for your life? Like, what is your plan in 10 years? And I said, I don't know. I said, because the reason I don't answer that question, I said, because if you would have asked me 10 years ago, would I be in here? I would have told you no. I wouldn't be no author. I wouldn't be motivating people. I'd probably be rapping somewhere or catching touchdown passes, right? But God has different plans for us. So accept that reality, embrace that reality, go through it. It's gonna suck, it's gonna hurt, but listen, as I always tell you guys, you will never get to your mountaintop if you're afraid to climb. Has anybody ever climbed a mountain before? The climb sucks, but the peak is beautiful. But you have to face your reality, own it, acceptance. And every day I tell myself when I have my problems, Trent, you got two options. Either you can sink or you're gonna swim. That's it. You can sink to opinions, your past, everything else, or you can swim with one thing, and that's faith. So reality is the first thing. Number two is release. There's some things in your life that you're holding on to that you need to let go of. I'll tell you that right now. And it's not always a person, it's not always a relationship, because there's some things that you need to fight for a relationship. But there's certain things in your life, maybe it's a mindset, maybe it's your past, that you need to let go of. And just understand this, a lot of times when you do better with your life, I've seen this all the time, people will try to bring up your past. As soon as you make a change, they'd be like, you talking about change, Trent, but you was the one turning up. Right, in elementary school. I'm like, what? Elementary school? Right, or middle school, high school, right? They hold on to your past because you got to realize something. I'll tell you why people do that. When you were that person, you were beneficial to them. They could benefit off of that. But when you make that change and that benefit leaves, they don't want to see a better you. They're used to seeing you for the you that benefited their life, from that old you. That's why I say you got to realize that some people just aren't going to be a part of your future. You got to leave some people behind. The journey might be lonely, but that doesn't mean, right, the journey is wrong. The path might be lonely. It might be ugly. It might be hard, but that doesn't mean the path is wrong. Some of the hardest, all the hardest paths lead to the most beautiful destinations. You got to realize that. So what are you holding on to that you need to let go of? Maybe it's your mindset, right? Maybe you need to get forgiveness, but it takes a release. Maybe it's your circle. I'm not trying to end any friendships at all, but a lot of times it's your circle. It's people around you, right? It's people around you that are bringing you down. When my circle got smaller, my vision got clearer. My circle, you see my circle. My circle is small. I don't travel with no big team. It's small, but we still make a big impact because I got the right mindsets around me. Mindsets are contagious. Whatever you consistently surround your life around, that's exactly what you're gonna be like. So look around, look at those people around you. It doesn't mean you have to be rude to them, but just you have to learn to love people from a distance sometimes, all right? So release. The third thing is repair. Repair. And whatever it is you're going through, repair is a hard process. All these are hard, but repair is a hard process because repair takes time, right? Repair is digging up those seeds, going to places that you don't want to go to again, that you try to forget, that you put in the back of your head thinking it's not going to exist no more, but it's still there controlling your life and your subconscious mind, and you're operating like that. But you have to dig up those negative seeds, because if you don't, those seeds will still be there, and you have to get down to the root. People ask me this question a lot, Trent, how do I get over a relationship, or how do I do this, or how do I stop accepting certain things? And like I said, that takes maybe going back to your childhood. Like some people, and I'll just paint a picture, I remember a teacher told me that I wouldn't be successful in life, or I wouldn't be able to be this or that. And that stuck with me a long time, because every time I tried to accomplish something, that came in the back of my mind. So I was telling myself I wasn't good enough. Because if you just leave things at surface level issues, like I tell people, it's not your relationship. The question is, why are you accepting the same things over and over and over again? Maybe that's what you've seen your mom or your dad, whatever it may be. Because if you don't get to the root issue of things, guess what happens? That problem finds its way back to the surface. Right? You can leave that old relationship, but if you still have the same habits, guess what happens in your new relationship? Same thing. Or if you don't forgive your past and your past relationship, that person, guess what happens? You bring all that to your new relationship, and you make a person pay for a mistake they didn't make. Right? So you have to learn to let go and repair your life. And that takes time. Like, nothing about change is pretty. Change is ugly. Change is hard. But you have to change daily to become a better you, right? And that responsibility is with you. I can tell you all these things today. Like, you can watch all the videos in the world. You can say, amen, clap, Trent, yes, it all starts with me, rehab time. That's great, you're inspired, but what happens when that situation comes back up again? What happens when that temptation shows its face again, right? What happens when the people give you opinions again? Because it's gonna come back. I believe the enemy works like, the devil's not creative. He uses the same things because he knows where your weaknesses are. But you gotta defeat those things. And sometimes you might fall and don't beat yourself up for it. But grow from that, grow from your mistakes. And understand, everything you went through was for a purpose. If I wouldn't have went through the things I went through, I couldn't stand here and talk in front of you guys. I couldn't make all those videos that I make, all 300 of them. I'm like, man, I'm now searching for content. I'm like, what else do I talk about, right? But I made a decision to change my life, and I made a decision to sign up for it forever. Does that mean I'm perfect? No, I'm not perfect, but I'm progressive, right? Life is not about perfection. It's about perfection, progression. There we go, right? Fall in love with progression. And just fall in love with the person you're becoming, okay? Fall in love with that person. And if nobody applauds you, pats you on your back, or none of that, who cares? Just keep falling in love with who you are, because somebody out there in the world needs you. Somebody's gonna appreciate you. If it ain't nobody else, make sure it's yourself. So look in the mirror and appreciate that image of you. However you look, appreciate it. I appreciate everything about me. I accepted my quote-unquote flaws. Anybody seen the Eminem 8 Mile movie? Hey, Mike, y'all seen it? You know the last scene when he's against Papa Doc? You know what I'm talking about? You know what he does? He like says everything about himself. And the dude is like, what do I do now, right? He owned himself. And that's what you got to do. When you own yourself, Trent, you got a bad passion. I already said all that. I own it. I don't care. Bring it up. Go on internet right now. You see me probably with a bottle in my hand somewhere. Back when I was playing football, I liked to show that because, for one, it shows how far I've came. For two, it shows you that it's real. And it shows that I'm human at that point. So make a difference with your life. Change your life. But like I say at the end of every single video, there we go. It all starts with you, all right?